Hello, you lovely people. Welcome back to my channel for another little shoot 'em up stunner, guys, that appeared on the PSP back in 2009, guys. This is a little gem. There has also been an ultra version released onto the Vita as well, guys, but we're looking at the original on the PSP, and this is a stunning little shooter, guys. It really is, with that floaty thing again, guys, you know, where you're floating around a bit like a cave crawler type thing, but it's still a fabulous shoot 'em up as well, as you are about to find out. Now, this was developed by Just Add Water, and it was released by Sony themselves, so fantastic. And it was actually released on the 24th of November 2009. So, I can't even begin to tell you how bloody awesome this game is, guys. Like I said, it's one of those shooters, guys, where you're going around almost like a cave system, and you're floating, and you know, you will keep floating and smack against the surrounding edges, and you will burst and, you know, explode in the end, guys, if you're not careful. So it does take some getting used to the controls on this game, but it is fantastic, guys. Absolutely fantastic. It is Gravity Crash, guys. Beautiful, beautiful game. Aesthetically beautiful. Now, this is like an 80s flipping arcade game, guys, in a sense. And it really, really is. Absolutely stunning looking game, as you are about to find out. Now, you can get bonus points and what have you if you collect your crew members. You can also kill your crew members, guys, as well. You can shoot them. But yeah, if you collect the crew members, then obviously you get bonus points at the end of each level. And also in this game, guys, you can design your own flipping map, if you like, or cave system, because it's an editor, guys. That is fantastic. Plus, there's a little hidden gem on there of a game that is just absolutely brilliant. It's called Gold Grabber, and we're going to look at that at the end. So what we're going to do in this video, guys, we're going to play the tutorial, because I think that probably shows it best, guys. We'll have a look at the, you know, the demos playing as well, and we'll do the tutorial. We'll go through that. That will give you a good guide on what this game is like. Fantastic, fantastic way of looking at it, guys, doing the tutorial, because it teaches you everything about it. So that if you do want to give this a go, you know where you're at. And then we'll go into Gold Grabber and have a go at that, because that is a little gem, guys, that you need to see. So yes, please join me as we jump back onto the fabulous, the wonderful PSP, guys, for Gravity Crash, guys. Hold on to your britches, back in a sec. Right, here we go, guys, with Gravity Crash Portable, a fantastic shoot 'em up. Oh, and a lot more to it than that even, guys. Fantastic little game for the PSP. Right, here we go. What we're going to do, guys, is we'll play the tutorial so you get to see it all. There's a nice little demo thing. You'll see what we've got to do there. So it's proper retro style, this, guys. All that from the 80s and the arcades. Right, let's get on with it, shall we? Start game. So you've got lots of choices here, guys, in the main menu. You've got start game, you've got editor. You've got play Gold Grabber. We're going to have to try that, aren't we? Auto playing options, so we're going to go back up to start game. So you can make your own things there, because you've got an editor, that's fantastic. We're going to go for pilot training, like I said. There we go. You've got to choose which one you want, which craft. They've all got their bits and bobs. Yeah, we'll go for the classic control. And we'll go to auto shield, so it detects it itself when it's needed. And then you've got a choice of plasma ball, drones, EMP, lightning. I do believe I used lightning last time, so we'll go for that again. Let's continue training. Right, here we go, guys. So, we've got to get those green things out, obviously. They are quite difficult to get at first until you get used to the controls a bit more, which I'm still not really, even after all these years. Later on you've got you know, mountains and stuff that you can clip and they will make you blow up if you're not careful. So basically this one you're just grabbing all these green gemmy looking things. There we go. Now you've got to locate the wormhole, which takes you to the next level. Here we go. Oh, you bugger, come on. There we go. Next lesson. And just continue. Come on. Next one, guys. Same again, but now you can see there's some landscape around. If you hit that, you will, of course, die. If you hit it too often, that is. I doubt I'm going to hit it. Oh, there we go. That's just to prove to you it damages you. There we go, see it. Oh dear. You can only take so many hits, guys, and then you do die. Right by the bloody wormhole, guys. Oh, I don't die. Oh, I hit it. I'm okay here because I'm not hitting any landscape. We'll be in a minute if I'm not careful. Oh, it's so difficult to get it. To get it right there. There we go. Next one. Okay. That's where you start shooting, guys. There we go. Oh, watch that landscape again. Yeah, you got that one. Oh. I do believe there's three to get on this one. Yeah. Oh, no. I just crashed straight into it, guys. Look at that. Oh, dear me. Before I get that one now. Don't you dare crash into it again. Get it, go on, get it. That's it, got it. I've got to find the wormhole again. It's over this way, there we go, nice one. What next? This is where you've got to hit a button at the top there, as you can see. Don't you hit that. You just got to get that. Once you got that, it will bring the wall down. Oh, you bugger, look how easy it is to slip up there. There we go, I've got it. Oh, but I'm just about to bloody die if I'm not careful. At least we've got it down. We've just got to get to that wormhole now. Oh, you bugger. Here we go. Oh, just in time. Right, so here we go. Oh, you bugger. Oh, we got it, we got it. I'm probably going to die, sir. We've got another one over there, No. Oh, bugger. That's going to be it soon. I think I'm running completely out of life here. Why did it bring the wormhole up already? Look at this one. Want it. Tread carefully, tiger, and all that. Mm. As you drift, obviously, and you stop. So, you know, I've got to be very careful. There it is. Yeah, we just got it, do we? Nearly. That's it, guys, we got it. Hopefully we still get to the wormhole as well. There we go, I just gotta get around that. Oh, there's another one there, look. Oh. Look at that. Another one. I'm not gonna make it, guys. Look. Oh, damn it. I'm fine. This is definitely a different kind of shooting up, isn't it? That's for sure. Not your usual kind of thing. Brilliant, absolutely brilliant. Oh, I'm listening to some of the others that have been around over the years. This whole drifting mechanic is quite something. Can you get it from here? But just about. Back up you go, go on, back up you go. No, don't hit it. Oh. How much more can this ship take, guys? Oh. That is the question. There you go. Oh dear. Now it's going to get me to play it again. There we go, playing it again. Get rid of it quick. Oh, you bugger. That was way too much, really. Oh, I'm going to do terrible this time. Terrible. You only have to get the one as well to get the wormhole up that looks it. Yeah, just the one. Oh, that's got it. Alright, shall I just head for the wormhole? I think so. We need to see the next level, don't we? Oh, but I'm so tempted, guys. So tempted by this one here. I've just gone out myself. I want it. Yes, got it. Okay. Oh, did lose a bit, but never mind. I'm not going to end up dying before I ever do it, am I? Yeah, I thought that would happen. Okay, one more go. You just got to get the one, guys, just the one. Did we get it? Yes, I think we did. Oh, yes, we did. Right, now we're going to go to the wormhole. We'll just leave the other two. There we go. Oh, that's what we're going to throw at us. Aha. Oh, right, okay. That's the ship we've got there, yeah. Okay. There's another ship. Oh, just literally went into him, didn't we? Oh, hey, nice one. Come on, you got back up there. There you go. Oh, we've got the wormhole already. Brilliant. Get back up there, come on. You stinker, come on. Perfect. Yes, did it. Cool. Alright, here we go then. Where are we going now? Oh, underwater, guys. Look. Underwater this time, and then up. Whoa, there's little people there, look. Oh, yeah, bugger. Are we supposed to rescue them or what? Ah, now we kill them, okay. I'm going to die before I kill the next one, probably. No, I did it. Oh, just did it, though, just did it. Bloody hell, eh? This is cool. What a cool, cool game this is, guys. But it does take some mastering, and I certainly haven't. Oh, I'm gonna shoot one of them, isn't it? Oh, there we go. Got one in. Got the other one, yeah. There's the bloody wormhole. Hey, did it. Wow. Data saving. Wicked. We didn't rescue all the crewmen. Never mind, saving crewmen is optional. But you will receive a bonus for doing so. Oh, cool. Well, guys, shall we find out what Plague Gold Grabber is? Let's go down. Use the analog stick to move, action buttons to fire. Okay. Oh, right, okay. Well, this looks pretty cool, doesn't it? To be honest. So you're supposed to grab these little bars here, I suppose. But how do you do it without getting... Ooh, like that, guys. Oh, dear. Right, okay. There's some gold there. Nice, I've got that. Where's the rest of it then? Bounce it. Oh, some over here, look. This is pretty cool, guys. What a cool little mini game. Wow. That is pretty wicked, guys, to have a little mini game like this. Oh, they got me again. Oh, dear. Right, straight down. There we go. Yes, got it. There's something over here. I don't know what that is. Oh, they seem to get you. Those flying disc things, I think I'll watch them. Yeah. What a cool little one. Oh, they got me, guys. Got the cornered me. Wow, but that is pretty cool. Right, one more go, guys. Here we go. Let's see if I can do any better. That is a pretty, pretty cool thing. Nice little touch to have that. I got it. Yes, I did get it in time. Yes, cool. Oh, God, they're coming from everywhere now. They're going to get... Oh, he got me. He was too bloody quick. Jeez Louise. Wow. Can I get it? Yes, I believe I got it. Oh, no, they're going to get me again. Oh, it's very, very difficult, guys. Very difficult, to be fair. Such a simple little thing. It's very, very difficult. Oh, they got me. I walked straight into that one. Yeah, absolutely brilliant that. Right, well, there we go, guys. That was a look at this fantastic game. It goes back to the main screen here. Once Goal Grabber's crushed you. Yeah, fantastic little mini game there as well. I think this is an awesome, awesome game. Obviously, we just looked at the training and Goal Grabber, guys. It kicks back into a demo here. There we go, but I think the training definitely showed you most things that you need to know. Absolutely fantastic game. A little blast of fun as a shoot 'em up, and obviously that little Goal Grabber game, which is a pretty cool thing as well. Right, back with my final thoughts, although I think you know where I'm heading with this.
What did you think of that then? Not bad for a 10-year-old game, eh? Nearly 11-year-old game, guys. I mean, wow. That is a little stunner, isn't it? The aesthetics of that, guys, is fantastic. It looks brilliant. And yes, it is very reminiscent of those 1980s games, guys. It really, really is. I think Just Add Water did a stellar job here. They have done some blinding games in the past, guys, but this is awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. But like I said, guys, you've got to get used to those controls. But yeah, what a game to have been released in 2009, guys. I mean, it was a proper little gem, wasn't it? I bet a lot of people just completely overlooked this. It is literally a hidden gem, guys. Hidden gem of a shoot-em-up. Yeah, it's not your traditional shoot-em-up where you're going along in a spaceship and you're just shooting everything that comes along, whether it's up or across, whichever way, you know. No, this is more like I said, a cave crawler, guys. You're going through, swimming around and all that, guys. Yeah, it is beautiful the way it works. And then, of course, you get the ships as well, like those little UFOs that turned up and whatever. Obviously, if you play the full game, guys, you get to see a hell of a lot more, as you saw in the demos that we're playing. Then we looked at that brilliant little hidden gem on there, Goal Grabber. Oh, my word. Is that a fabulous little thing, guys? Oh, again, so 80s, it's unbelievable. There's been many, many games, guys, that are just like that game. But so fun. Absolutely fun. You know, where you're having to, you know, obviously grab the gold, grab all the other items before the bloody enemy gets you. All those bloody discs fly across, don't they, and they hit you. Yeah, it's absolutely stunning. What a fun, you know, fun, I should say, fun. Fun little thing to have on the game, guys. Yeah, just a little added bonus. Brilliant. And then, of course, we didn't look at it, but there is the you know, the editor, guys, where you can make up your own cave system in a way, isn't it? So yeah, what a fantastic gem, hidden gem for the PSP. But what did you think of this? Comment below, guys. Do you think this looks brilliant, or do you think it's a bit underpowered for something like the PSP, guys? But I think that is the point here. This is a retro throwback, and that was the point of the game all along. But do you feel that it isn't much cop? Because not everybody's going to have the same opinion as me, who thinks that it's bloody wonderful. So yes, guys, like I said, comment below. And with that, guys, yeah, I'm going to wrap things up and I'm going to say the usuals. If you're not subbed already, please drop me a sub. Give me a bummy thumbs up if you feel that way inclined. And of course, don't forget to tap the bell icon and the all icon to get any future notifications whatsoever. And then, guys, if you like these retro style games, guys, I mean, the PSP is getting pretty retro itself, isn't it? Yeah, you might love emulation, guys, whether it's a home system or, you know, handheld like an Ambinic or PowKiddy or whatever handheld you're going for. I've got a fantastic group for you on Facebook. It is the Retro Emulation Fan Group that me and my best mate Nate set up quite some time ago. We now have a fabulous admin team behind us. We have an ever-growing member base that is reaching, just a cat's whisker away from 500 members. So there's plenty of members to have a banter with. Tons of videos for you to watch, from emulation performance videos to system reviews and tech help videos and a whole lot more. So if you just love emulation, links below, guys, head over and come and join us. And then, guys, I also have my UK Crap Gaming Facebook group as well, where we cover everything from retro to modern gaming, Pong machines to PS5s and everything in between. And again, tons of videos there, guys, as well, because other YouTubers are putting their videos up there every single day. So there's a ton of content for you. And again, guys, fantastic admin team behind it as well to answer any questions you may have. So yeah, if you just love gaming of any kind, as long as it's video games, we don't want none of them board games. But yeah, anything to do with video games, guys, linked below again. Hello, ask to join and I'll accept you in no time. And then finally, guys, I have a Patreon. Again, there's a video there explaining why I set it up in the first place. It is down below again, the link. Head over there. Just give that a watch, guys, and see if you want to join me on my Patreon journey. And with that, guys, I'm going to love you and leave you and say auf Wiedersehen, tschüss, and goodbye. And I'll see you in the next one, guys. Bye-bye.